Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the second game of Monday Night Football doubleheader. Actually, no, this would be Sunday Night Football doubleheader. I got my days mixed up. And we are looking at the Cobras, the home team, facing off against the Cowboys. Cowboys are the visiting team. I am your host, Tom Box, and I am joined here by Greg Stella. What's up, Greg? How you doing?
Hello, hello. Yeah, we're here ready for the Cowboys versus the Cobras. Should be a good game, be an interesting game. See if Flo can, if he's taken the QB spot, whether he can pull it together and maybe cause an upset here. I think the Cowboys are favorite to win this one. But let's see what they can do.
Absolutely. Well, this week has had a couple of those a couple of those favored wins, upsets for some people, excitements for a lot of the panel on the Pulse, mainly speaking of your game, was a great one there. So looking forward to this one. The Cobras have really been doing their best and working forward. They have not given up, so they've got the determination. They have made some changes. You've got Flo Burner on the team now. And the last time I saw the Cobras out, they did. It looked like it was a completely different team. So I'm greatly looking forward to seeing what they can do now, and what they bring into the table. So the coin toss is up. It's spinning downfield, Never mind. I was gonna make a funny, but I lost it.
Yeah, it looks like we got. That's Razden's new account, isn't it? Raz09.
Yep, that's Razden. We got Razden as a head referee. Bob. Got Bob out there. And
I was saying that the Cobras were down a player, but it looks like the person's on the sideline. So
yep.
They do have 9 players, so that's good. You Cobras tend to... They're one of those teams that have been struggling getting the right amount of players and stuff like that, and occasionally on one team they might have the full 9, and occasionally they might lose one because of, I guess, real life commitments or whatever, which doesn't help. I mean, we're prone to it. We started our game last night down a player.
Absolutely.
It's what happens when people start being upset that they're on the bench and stuff.
You've got real life situations that, like last night, one of our starters, was working late and he was unable to play the game, because of that. So sometimes, it just happens like that, and it's completely understandable. But luckily both these teams have enough on their roster to actually be here. We're actually going to get to see some football going down.
Yep. Should be an interesting game. Cowboys have got some good players. They see who they are fielding today. We've got Billy. We've got Superficial Swag, my favorite name ever. Sifontis, King Q Sky, Durgan, who I'm sure will be QBing today. We've got only 6 picks, or 1 pick. But he got 6 the last game, so he had to change his name.
Oh, I was really confused for a second there.
Got Horns, Tony, Ragu, and Galen. Now, there's one trend I've noticed during the top 5 plays of the last couple of weeks. Durgan to Galen, deep down the field. That's a big thing you've got to watch today. I reckon the Cobras' safeties won't be able to handle that, and we might see a huge play between Durgan and Galen there.
Absolutely. So it looks like the Cowboys are set to kick off. Still waiting here. I'm not sure what's going on. And just to let everybody know out in Twitch land, right now I am streaming from the fan side of things. So we're not going to hear the snaps nor the referees on this side. I'll be commentating as well as streaming. So just so everybody knows, so nobody's asking, why don't we hear sound? So you get to hear, get to hear me while I commentate and stream. So, lucky you guys. I'm having a blonde moment right now. I shaved all my hair off, so I'm having a blonde moment because all the blonde hair is kicking out. What was I about to do?
For what?
What was I about to do? Ah, I was going to load up the Twitch stream and make sure the Twitch stream is going. Good. Man, it's already started. The game hasn't even been kicked off.
So I have just spoken to Razdan, and I will bug him for any flag.
Perfect.
Queries and stuff like that. On the Cobras side today, we have Sierra, Jasmine, Herbert, Shadow Wolf, Mado. And in the backfield in the middle here, we've got Trey Steele, Flo Burner, Mako, and Kovu. And that ball went out short, which is going to start the Cobras off in really good position on the 40-yard line.
Absolutely. I apologize for missing that kick there, folks on the Twitch stream. I'm on it now.
Flo is playing QB tonight. Looks like they're going to trust him in this game as well. He's got Kovu and Trey to the left, Jasmine and Mako to the right. He's got Mado in the backfield with him. And the offensive line is Shadow, Herbert, and Sierra. See what they can do on their first place. Flo snaps the ball, rolls to the right. He's got the blocks he needs.
Got a long lane right there.
10 yards, almost 15 yards. He picks up 14 yards on that carry. Good first play.
Absolutely. His blockers got out there, grabbed the block, allowed him to get the outside. And he was just able to shoot up. You know, the cornerback finally got in there to stop that forward progress even more, to turn, you know, so that 15 didn't turn into 25 or 35.
Definitely not something you would normally see from the Cobras, having a really good first play there.
Absolutely.
Flo snaps the ball, rolls to the left, and he's got a little bit of pressure to the left. He manages to roll around it. He's got a player open deep. Looks like he was going for the shorter receiver.
Yeah, that's what it looked like to me, but he overthrew it, and then if it was going for the back receiver, because we had both two receivers open. But he either overshot the short one or undershot the deep one. Yeah. So
either way, it was a bad throw.
Absolutely.
So either of them.
And I thought he was going to run for it because he activated sprint, started hauling butt to the side there. He might have just saw that receiver right at the end. So Horns almost with a stumble there.
Decided he had to go to the right.
Throwing cross field.
Left side again, cross field, and misses again.
Absolutely.
Now, Cobra's receivers, they're not known for adjusting, and Flo hasn't been playing QB for very long. So, you know, his perception, his depth perception of how high you've got to throw it to get it to the receiver might not be spot on.
Absolutely.
Their adjusting might not be spot on. So
wall of blockers there. He's rolling out. Ooh. And the Cowboys just closed that up. They saw the run that was coming and just decided to close it.
So fourth down and 12. I would say just kick it.
It's,
if you had a good run, just kick
it. Kind of too early in the game to give a turnover right here at your 50. So, punting formation is out.
While they do that, we'll do our first sponsor, Glaze. Glaze is a supplier of a wide range of slink nails for both men and women. No holds barred. If it fits on a nail, we shall do it, from the unusual wacky styles to the more natural look, including no polish nail appliers. We also offer some slink hand tattoos. That was just a kick straight out of bounds.
That's right. Quick kick, and it just went right out of bounds. Now, if there's one thing that Flo is comfortable on, Flo is comfortable kicking the ball.
Yeah.
So, also to the Twitch world, I do want to apologize. We do not have any of the HUDs up for the field, so I will be camming on the scoreboard every so often, so you guys know.
Duggan hikes.
Oh!
Pressure. He's fumbled.
Fumbled. Knocked out way
Sierra
deep.
Didn't pick up on that straight away, and I've actually frozen, so I don't know what happened the rest of the play.
It was picked up by Hartooni in there. That's Durgan. He went off to the left-hand side, got all the way to the 21-yard line on the recovery. So he recovered it at about the 1.5-yard line and was able to gain it back. But man, that ball shot out like a lightning bolt out of his hands. I mean, it went
right
far.
Now, And he stood on the 10-yard line, and the ball's on the 2-yard line.
So Durgan takes a snap, rolls out to the center. He's going up. He's got the first down, and then some. He's got blockers ahead of him. He swoops out to the left-hand side. He only has one defender left to get him. He's getting the angle. Oh, he's continuing going. He's got a line of three, and he gets taken down at the 40 for a gigantic pickup there. Fantastic run. A pickup of about 39 yards.
That was a really good play. 39-yard pickup. Not going to say no to that one. Durgan rolls to the right now. He's got a little bit of pressure from Herbert, but the block gets picked up on him. He's got space to run it. He jukes around Jasmine, gets the first
down. Another junk.
Tackle coming from behind.
He would have had plenty more, but he had that one little quick little stumble there that got him.
Yeah, he started juking about a little bit early. Somebody came up behind him. Took him down, but this is a good go by the Cowboys.
Absolutely.
They're moving the ball. They haven't had any problems except for that early fumble, but you know, can't help that.
And a quick sack there by...
That's Trey Steele.
Trey Steele. Yeah, I'm looking at jerseys and numbers, so I don't... by Senor Steele there. So, fantastic sack on the play there to drop the Cowboys back a couple yards.
Durgan rolls to the left. He had a little bit of pressure from Mader there. Throws it up into the middle.
Mm.
Not anybody there, though.
No, he whizzed it over the head of his receiver. So, as Billy said yesterday, he got a little bit too much mustard on that one. And then Pasta was really confused. It's got mustard on his hands. He was very confused.
He was confused. I liked his other saying, you don't plant corn to grow peaches.
Yeah.
Or the other way around. But
and another tackle there, another sack.
A loss of three.
By number 42. Cowboys. That's a great number.
Herbert.
That is a great number.
A lot of 42s on... playing the line, isn't
there? You know, when I started, I was the only 42, so I'm the original, and they're the imitators. So a field goal formation coming up, so it looks like the Cowboys are going to just take the points, which is smart, and it's something that we haven't seen a lot of this during the beginning of the season, and it's only now when there's, you know, pretty big playoff implications coming up, and you've got these teams just fighting it hardcore for points, you know, that you see these field goals coming. Because, you know, you guys, you know, you got it down the field, marched in on the field, got in range. You know, most teams would just say, you know, we'll just go for it. But, you know, it's a smart move, putting points on the board. If you march it down that far, there is no reason not to go for the field goal. Because if you march that hard down the field and then give it up, I mean, that's really deflating. It can really kill a lot of momentum.
Yeah, I mean, we looked at it this way. If we didn't go for the kicks, the three field goal, no, sorry, two field goals that we had, that's six less points
Absolutely.
That we would have had at the end. And, you know, if they got a touchdown and then missed a kick, that's, we're covering that touchdown.
Absolutely. I had you guys on the pulse winning by three, and I was like, oh my gosh, there's the field goal. There it is. And I was like, well...
Yeah, no, I mean, we just carried on going. So Flo's second chance at getting some points here. And yet again, on the first play, he's got...
Oh, and a phenomenal block on the outside right there.
15 yards.
Oh, man. That was a fantastic block on the outside and allowed Flo just to cut inside and get an extra about 5 to 6 yards just from that block. So he should be patting his blocker on the back.
To be honest, I think he needs to be... channeling his running shoes today, because that's where he's having all the luck right now.
Absolutely.
He's still fresh at throwing the ball, so he's missed every throw.
Yep.
Run it. He's had some really good runs, so just try and run it. Rolling to the left, he isn't having much luck because he's got a little bit of pressure, but he manages to get a catch.
And a nice completion there. Absolutely.
Jasmine just kind of stood there in the middle. Galen was right there next to her.
I thought he'd already jumped the route. I saw it as a pick coming, but she was able to get right in front and come down with the ball.
Yeah, I thought that was going to be picked by Pick. No, it was good going by the Cobras there. Good eye for Flo there. Flo snaps the ball, rolls to
A
right,
great
through
block on
the
the middle there,
air,
rolling
bounces to
outside.
the outside, and just short of the 10, he picks up 8 yards there.
Absolutely. His
Again,
line
really good play.
is on point with the blocks right now, allowing him to get plenty of yards. You know, and Flo is confident enough and is comfortable enough running that he knows when he gets the block, he knows if he needs to go to the inside or outside, and he's shown that, you know, this second drive, the first drive and this second drive, so.
Yeah, I mean the problem I can see that they're having on and
Oh,
hand off there
hand off to
for
the
the
first
first
down.
down.
Absolutely. That's all you need. Another set of downs for the
Yeah,
Cobras.
the problem I'm seeing on the Cowboys side of thing, Q's doing absolutely fine. He's got the pressure on Flo, but Horns is going too wide and letting Flo have a gap, which is going to be good for the Cobras, and it'd be interesting to see whether the Cowboys close that up. Flo snaps the ball, fake handoff to the right, and he gets the pressure from
Oh.
Q. As I said, you know, Q's just he's right there. He's ready for the sack.
Yeah, and Horns was playing. She was playing actually in front of the line of scrimmage on that one. She wasn't pushing in to give any type of pass rush or anything like that. Now, I mean, it worked out that pick got in there, but now she's going to the middle.
Gets all the blocks on Q that time. Flo rolls to the right, throws it open to the left to
Oh.
Jasmine, and she just misses it.
Yep, she did a she had a she had she correct she went to one side. If she would have stayed on that route, she would have been
She
right there
zigged
under the ball.
instead of zanged.
That's right. I think we've all been there. So I you
Yep.
know.
I've been there plenty of
Oh
times.
yeah.
So, not a bad display here from the Cobras, but definitely improved since picking up Flo and
Absolutely.
Coho. Flo drops back, but we've got a
Oh,
dead
we got a dead
ball
ball penalty.
penalty, so I am going to go for an add. Looks like it's going to be a false start on the home team, the Cobras there. The Tigers dance team and Little Paws are elite, one-of-a-kind team that strike fear, awe, respect, and envy in the heart of the competition across the grid. Never ceasing to amaze the crowd, they bring high energy, talent, and fun to every event. Contact Samantha, which is SN Dubois resident, or Shea Harcourt today to join the hottest dance team in SL or to book a performance. You can also like them on Facebook, which I will paste out in local. So Flo getting a 5 yard penalty there for the false start. They're gonna have to throw it long here. He's looking for the open receiver, throws it out to the left, and it's caught by Kovu, and he's gonna
Oh, and
go
he gets.
to
Oh,
Kovu's gonna
man.
put it
I thought he
in.
was going to get out of that stumble and get in for
Big
six.
play. Big play there. They definitely needed that.
Six, yeah.
I thought that was going to be picked off, but that was a huge play by Kovu.
Great
A little
adjustment
bit,
on the ball there.
yeah, a little bit misread by the safety there, and Kovu managed to come down with it. Might even see a run from Flo here. He's waiting
Looks like
for the gap.
he's trying to open
He's
it up.
waiting for the gap.
Here he
Everybody's
goes.
bunched up where he is, and he runs it out the 2 yard line. Manages to pick up 4. That'll make it a little bit easier on this next play.
Absolutely.
One problem though, every Cobra came to the middle, and that closes everybody up in the middle. The receivers need to spread a bit more, so there's more gaps. Kovu hikes the ball, rolls to the left. He's
Trying to
got
find it.
Kovu,
Here
but
he's
he's
got it.
just
Oh, and I
four.
saw a foot go in and break the line.
Yeah, he's got 1 yard there.
I don't know if the refs are going to watch the stream for that one.
I don't think that was it. I don't think that was quite it. So
Well, that gets him even closer. So,
Flo's gonna
oh,
try
he's got a
again. He's
heavy
got the
rush now.
pressure. He's got a little bit of
There he
gap, and he
is.
goes for it. I think that is
Oh,
a
he's.
touchdown.
Yeah, that's a touchdown.
It's
They
gotta be.
need to give that to him because his body was still upright when he broke the line into the end zone. So.
Saying fourth and minus one on the 1/2 yard line, and they give it. They give
Absolutely.
it. The Cobras have got a touchdown.
Now this is definitely
What did I say?
it's refreshing to see. It's refreshing to see a team like this completely turn around. It doesn't matter when in the season that they do it. It's just, it's just nice to see a team turn around and make something of their of the team,
I mean, I said it. I'm pretty sure we were on air at the time. We might see an upset here, and
Yeah, we were live at that
yeah,
current moment.
at the murmur,
At that
derp,
moment.
derp, derp,
Derp-a-derp. Wow,
derp.
that just happened.
And while you're having that moment, I'll talk about Peach. Peach is known for its unique and creative accessories and hair, often inspired by the creator's personal interests, nostalgia, and current. 100% all original mesh, customers can be confident in their shopping experience for originality. Geek. So the ball is kicked to the Cowboys. Galen comes down with it. He's usually pretty good on his feet. Running it down
Absolutely,
the left-hand
making
side, drops
good
in
foot moves there to
and
get him up.
taken down after 31 yards by Flo. And now the Cowboys are gonna see if they can get a touchdown, or whether they just end up with three, or whether they end up with nothing.
They definitely need to answer back on this touchdown to keep the Cowboys from getting, because I'm sorry, to keep the Cobras from scoring it. Because I mean, they've only got 3 points on the board. They need to answer back, take the lead, and force the Cobras to have to
Score
start
again.
looking, at the end zone more. Can't let them get comfortable
Galen's
with that
got the pressure.
touchdown.
He's going deep to Galen
Oh, and
Turner.
a
What did I
beautiful
say?
pass.
What did I
Oh
say?
man, this is going to
Another one.
be a game.
Another
Wow.
one of my predictions from the beginning of the game was that long ball to Galen down the middle, and it just happened. So let's see how Durgan can handle the red zone. I know some teams find it harder to pass the ball.
Absolutely. I've been
He's
there
gonna.
before during pickups. Oh, and he finds a beautiful hole and he's in for the touchdown. Touchdown, Cowboys. Putting another
Really
six
good
on the
play.
board.
Two plays,
Oh.
7 points,
Yep.
puts them ahead by three.
Absolutely. Pending the extra kick. There it
So
is.
while they get ready for the kick, let's do SL Live Radio. They are your virtual life's number one radio station in true HD sound quality, offering you the hottest DJs, spinning the freshest mixes on the grid. Live, SL Live Radio, radio for your second life. For more information, contact Esme, Capello, or Thorn and Dell. And since they haven't kicked it yet, I'll go for Blueberry. Blueberry is an original clothing store for women, made by a woman with a passion for art. It's Blueberry. Flow with the
Blueberry,
ball.
a huge sponsor of the UFL, doing multiple different sponsorships with us.
Sponsors the Pulse and the Power Ranking show.
Oh,
Actually
nope, she
makes
doesn't.
things.
Nope,
Oh,
she
she
is not a
doesn't.
sponsor of the Pulse. Nope,
Pulse.
she
Oh,
went
okay.
Power Rankings and
I make stuff every week for them.
absolutely. No, she's Blueberry's phenomenal. It's one of those
She's.
stores, and it's one of those people that you just really enjoy talking to, just down to earth, and just really makes some phenomenal product.
And she always comments on my top five plays, so for that I'm forever grateful.
Yep,
Flo
absolutely.
snaps the ball, rolls to the left-hand side. He's got time and space. He could run it, and
Lots
he's
of
gonna
room.
run it.
Lots of running
And
room.
he manages to
Oof.
pick up about 10 yards
Nine
before.
and like an inch, maybe, or he's got about an inch to
It
go.
says 10 yards, but he's still got an inch to go. Might
I mean, I'm
go
zoomed in on
now.
it right now, and it looks pretty
No.
close.
Yeah, it is literally an inch away. So we might just see a quick QB sneak here, that right down the middle, just to pick up that inch. And no, he's going to drop back. He's actually looking for a pass, which is surprising. He hasn't got the pressure he needs, but he does have the space he needs. He stumbled, and that's actually made him lose a yard there.
Ouch.
So.
I would have definitely ran that one just to get the yards,
I would
or
have run
to
it
get the first
sooner.
down.
Yeah, I would have run that sooner.
But we can sideline quarterback all we want, until it's you in the trenches down there. It's a completely different story, so.
Yeah, I mean, how we got a timeout by the Cowboys here. that they might need to TP somebody in or something. But while they do that, then let's do the next sponsor, which is A&A Designs. Are you looking for that special piece of jewelry, whether it be elegant or trendy, formal or for a wedding? Come along to Diamante, A&A's very own jewelry line, and see what we have for you. Were you looking for slink enhancement add-ons? We carry both a wide range of nails and shoes that will complete any outfit. While you're there, don't forget to check out the A&A to find out that perfect gift for the perfect somebody. Diamante and A&A, because life is your creativity.
I almost have them all memorized.
I was gonna say, were you mouthing along as I was?
I was. I was actually reading along as you were as you were reading it out. Well, I mean, we've been doing this since day one, so.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I still pull up the note card because I'm sure I'll probably get it wrong.
Oh yeah, 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 yeah.
Yeah.
I can't say that I know them all 100% word for word, but I know a good bit of it.
Yeah.
I'm just sad I never got to read the fun one from What Radio.
The What For Play.
Yeah, I never got to read that. I was really bummed out about that. I really wanted to do it.
I kept missing it.
And I know
the day I would commentate, it was like the day before. So I always missed it. Flo snaps the ball, rolls out to the right-hand side. He hasn't really got space to run it this time. He's got one, two...
Well, like one of his blockers... People. One of his blockers was just standing still right there at the snap, so he was down one blocker, and that's where all that extra pass rush came from.
He also had six people coming in.
Oh, well, that can cause some problems, too.
He must have had a corner come in somewhere as well. Cowboys obviously not worried about the passing game. They're more worried about Flo's running.
Oh, my gosh, at this rush. So stumbled. Flo, he's going to get out of the stumble.
He's got out of the stumble,
ooh. Not enough. And it's a turnover on downs.
Durgan manages to sweep up on that one, and it is a turnover on downs. They only needed 1 yard, so I don't know.
That pass in the beginning, I really think it hurt him.
Yeah. I don't really know whether that was worth it. I mean, it was 1 yard.
User joined.
Should have been
channel.
Easier to get it than he did.
Absolutely.
Durgan hikes the ball. Rolls to the right, he's got time, he's got space, he's got Galen deep down the middle again, but he throws it short. Looked like it was going to Kovu, if anything. But no harm, no foul, it just drops in the dirt and does nothing. He should have looked absolutely deep down the middle there. He had Galen wide open again. I'm sure Galen was shouting on TeamSpeak.
Absolutely.
Cowboys use. So, Doug,
so if
he's got a
they're...
little bit of pressure.
Yeah, they
got a receiver open on the left, but it goes in the dirt and does.
Yeah, the Cobras are answering back with a 5-man rush as well. So.
Yeah, I mean, I think with Durgan, if he's got pressure, then he's a bit rushed to throw the ball. And as you can see on the last two plays, he's just thrown it in the dirt both times. Sturgeon hikes the ball, rolls to the right. He's got space to run it if he needs to, and he's going to. And he manages to pick up at least 10 yards, picks up 12 yards for the first down, and then gets taken down by Kovu.
What's up, Greg and Tom?
Hey, man.
Hello, Eric.
Hey, I figured I'd come in, give y'all here so Tom can head down.
Well, that works. Yeah, I can. I'll jump on the field over there at halftime and.
Durgan hikes the ball, rolls left, got the blocks he needs.
Stumbled.
Got pressure from Sierra. Stumbled.
Thrown away.
And he throws it away, way up into the corner of the sim. Second down and 10. I'm sure they'll manage to pick up the 10, but Cobra's putting on the pressure here. Sierra was unlucky to get the tackle there.
Guys, I apologize for all the bings in the background.
Durgan hikes the ball. He's got a little bit of pressure from Troy. The offensive line of the Cowboys not really doing much blocking here.
No, they're struggling a little bit.
Durgan's
oh,
got the time.
Batted
Troy
down.
Bats the ball down. Troy kept the pressure on pretty much that whole play. Even though he wasn't getting the tackle, he manages to get the bat down and gives the Cowboy a 3rd and 10 to deal with. Bergen's calling the shots, giving the plays, telling everybody where to go. He's saying, for God's sake, just be open and get those blocks.
And block. Oh, there he goes. Now he's got some time.
He's got some time.
He's got a receiver.
Got Galen and tackled by Mako almost straight away. But he does manage to get the first down. And we're back again in the red zone. Got to watch out for Durgan running this in because he did that last time. So let's see what the Cowboys can do here. Durgan hikes the ball. He's got a little bit of pressure, but nothing really. He's got more pressure again. He can't run it in. He's got to try and throw it here, and he throws it.
Oh, and Galen just
a little bit wide.
Oh man, I think he was expecting it to go straight to him.
Yeah, Galen. Yeah. It was right to him, and he moved out of the way of it.
Yep.
It was right where it needed to be, and he kind of ran out of bounds.
Oh yeah, it was pick. It's the hair. I'm pretty sure they both have the same hair or something.
Similar. I don't know. Picks is a little more wild than Gale.
And Durgan rolls the right. He's looking for the run again. He's got the pressure. Runs straight into Shadow Wolf there. Doesn't really go anywhere. Of course. Yeah. Yeah. One's dreads and one's like poofed out.
Well, I don't know the difference, so.
Apparently I don't either. That's why I'm calling them the wrong name. So Durgan hikes the ball, rolls to the right.
Oh, he's got a block for the outside. Oh!
But he's got the tackle there.
I believe that was Jasmine that just came up and shot over and just bulldozed him down.
4th and 3.
And they're going to go for it.
They're going to go for it. He hasn't had any luck lately, but let's see if he can punch it in. Even if they turn over on downs here, they could get a safety from it.
Absolutely.
Anyway. So it's they're gonna go for it. So Durgan hikes the ball, drops back a little bit. He is
waiting for that block to happen. Holy moly! He had three Cowboys there in the corner, just standing there.
And pick getting his only one pick that he's allowed. And Cowboys pending the kick. Go up by a touchdown and a field goal. So we'll Cobras really need to answer with a touchdown here. They'll put them within 3.
Absolutely.
Just to close, they've got to close that gap. Even if they pick up that 3, even if they get a field goal, and then pick up the 7 later, just to close the gap. They've proved that they can stop the Cowboys. I mean, they stopped them to a 4th down. Twice in that drive.
Yep, absolutely.
The Cowboys were just lucky to then get that through. So while they do that, I will do the next sponsor, which is Honey 103. Tune in to KHMY Honey 103 for a smooth romantic blend of R&B, neo soul, and soul, 24/7, 365. Perfect music to groove to as you're enjoying time with your lover or unwinding after a long day of work. Either visit www.honey103.com or grab that stream and add it to your land. Honey 103, your soul satisfaction, a division of Macchiato Media.
Greg, you want to tune to Honey 103 later and go to a drive-in movie?
Yeah. Only if you buy me a root beer float.
We'll split one.
I don't know about that. I'm pretty greedy.
I am too.
I might have to cough up the extra cash for a second one.
All right. I won't be a cheap one. We'll get two big ones.
You're getting all those donations, you should be able to afford it.
Yeah. Okay. Have I talked about the deficit I'm in? Let's just say I'm just gonna say two words: medical bills.
Oh, medical bills are always.
All right, well, while the refs are deciding which glove fits on which hand, I will talk about Gut Bucket. a themed 1950s throwback region, googie, bowling malls, stunning area to relax, dance, and hang out with friends. Some of SL's top designers, including Mad Pete, Meshworks, Moda, Sinful, Delirium Style, Hadra, Popisty, 2013, Identity, Deadpool, Seven Deadly Skins, Deer, and many more. Beautiful and eye-catching for photography, blogging, and finally a small area to have a private wedding with a minister and the full use of props.
Alrighty.
And looks like they're still deciding which glove fits on which hand. No, Razdan, you put it on this one. But Bob, it fits on this one as well.
Either that or someone's making sock puppets.
Yeah. They're, let me just go down to the concessions and get myself a hot dog with lots of mustard. Well, I guess I should probably do a sponsor. Might as well get them out
yep.
of the way.
I'm just in here chatting in local.
Yeah, SL is a feed specifically for creators in Second Life, featuring new releases, vendor ads, and store information directly from the creators themselves. Owned by Aliana Logan, there is no cost to join the feed or the in-world group. Sister feeds are Blogging SL for fashion bloggers, Hunting SL featuring media announcements and information on events in SL of all types, and Living SL featuring the blogs of residents who share information about Second Life.
I'm totally being called a cheap date right now.
You are. I mean, if you're gonna want to split one, then
hey, I was going for the romantic vibe for splitting one. You know, like two straws in there, our noses touching while we're drinking the root beer float. I mean, come on.
Oh god.
Oh god. Oh god. I'm gonna get a message after this game going ... from Matt. I just know it.
There's so many like. What do they call them? Bromances.
Oh yeah.
That go on.
The UFL is filled with bromance.
Yeah. You've got Dre and Billy, I think it is. Apparently now me and Tom. Not sure if there's many others actually. There's probably just those two.
The bromance bug is going around.
Apparently. So that's, don't know what exactly is going on here. The refs are lining up in front of Superficial Swag.
Uh-oh.
His name's got too many swags in it, and it, he's
or he's just or he's just too superficial.
Swag. Maybe he's too superficial.
If we had a on the field reporter, we might know what's going on.
Well,
so
you know,
Razdan, but I'm sure he's busy.
We never mind. Oh boy, one of those days. But you know,
lighting a joint or something.
We don't talk about illegal activities like that, especially on stream.
Of course, nobody in the UFL does any of that.
Nope.
I'm not responsible for the words I just said. Though, wouldn't it depend on what state he's in?
True.
He's
in the UK.
Twitch.
English. Yeah, he's English.
Well, Twitch is based in the US, so they have to follow US rules. So anything broadcasted that go against the federal law, they have to uphold. So doesn't matter where you're from.
So yeah, it wouldn't matter if you're in a state that.
That is correct. That is correct. You
follows federal.
That's correct. Yeah, you can't do any type of anything, any drugs on stream, anything like that. So,
yeah. Yeah, that Snoop Dogg.
No, he's not Snoop Dogg anymore. He's Snoopzilla.
Oh.
Snoopzilla.
You were talking about that yesterday.
I was. I even Googled it to double check.
All right. Well,
Alrighty, so this is where we do a little pre-halftime show, and Greg gets up and dances.
No, hard pass.
Right, Greg's going to table dance for us.
Hard pass. Although, saying that, I will be at the lingerie bowl doing a bit of cheerleading.
I will be too. Be right there with you. I don't know if we're on the same team, though.
No, we'd be on opposite teams.
Oh, that's right, we're different divisions. Herpaderp. Yeah. Well,
you get to cheerlead against each other.
That's right. I'm going to like growl and I'm going to rush the other cheerleader stand. Yeah, like a cheerleader brawl, not a bra, but a brawl. Oh boy, where's my mind?
They're trying to take back the touchdown for the Cowboys.
Oh wow.
Oh, maybe he stepped out of bounds before he caught the ball or something maybe. Oh, I'm saying somebody did pass interference.
That would have had to be like right inside the back of the end zone, though.
Yeah.
Well, it was only on like the 2 yard line.
I think it was on the two or the four, something like that.
Well, I hope my cameras were. I hope my camera for the stream was on par.
Oh yeah, they already ran.
Yeah, they already ran the extra point.
So Razin says pass interference in the end zone. While I was checking, they kicked the extra point. I'm talking to the QBs.
Ah.
Well, they could just take the points off, pull the ball back.
Yeah, there'd have to be some manual adjustments there.
Add like a minute to the time.
Hmm. Where's my Jeopardy music? I need like a sound. I need like a soundboard to play like oh and stuff like that.
Yeah. Well, while they're still.
So they looks like in chat, there's sounds like they're taking it back.
Which I mean they should.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah. Exactly. If something was wrong with it.
A replay of the fourth down.
Inna saying it's legal in some places, but we're going to be in trouble if they ban bromances. I agree. I will be exceptionally sad if they ban a bromance because I mean I got multiple bromances going on. I'm an open bromance type of guy.
Gonna have to fight all my other boyfriends.
Oh yeah yeah.
All right, welcome back.
Moving on.
Still lead innovator in high quality 100% original mesh and clothing aimed for the football community within SL with a wide range of products from jerseys, cleats, helmets, compression clothing, uniforms, hand warmers, gloves, and much more. That's Combatant. Leave your mark.
Combatant, another huge sponsor of the UFL. The Combatant will be—I don't know if I can say that yet. Okay, so I'm not going to pass that. Combatant will be—is sponsors of the Player of the Week for the Pulse Show.
Here's my question: so they have cleats this season.
Yep.
What will it be next season?
You know, I don't know. Maybe we'll do Player of the Game, Player of the Week gloves. Maybe
that's
some like golden gloves or something
golden
like that.
Gloves.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gloves that I'll never get.
I think that would look really cool. You could have
thank you, Troy Barrera.
you could have like the week where the little finger is, or like that side of the hand, and then like the week on the index finger. You could do the same pattern that's on their most recent gloves, but in gold and black. I think that'll look good.
Yeah. Oh, just you know, you just make them to match the cleats.
Or match the cleats, so that everybody who got Player of the Week this year wants the gloves
to match. Because I mean, you look at everybody on the field. I mean, we're not only football players; we're fashionistas. I mean, come on.
Well, you got to match.
Exactly. Like, never once have I seen a larger group of men making sure their uniforms match and their colors match. In my life, so I mean.
Yeah, looking at Durgan, he's got the USA gloves.
Yep.
With some blue star cleats. which I think are the Cowboys ones.
Actually. Yep, I mean, and look at his towel and his quarterback wristband. They're both red.
Yep. He's accessorizing there.
Absolutely. You know, Horns has her matching, but I mean, that's Horns.
He's got
like
that pink going on.
Yeah, and you've got Q here with the. I'm sorry, that's Pick. You got Pick here with the blue face mask to match his jersey.
Yeah, Fontes has got the matching cleats and gloves there.
So, like I said, accessorizing. I mean, and I can't say anything. I've got, you know, I've got my radioactive gloves and my radioactive cleats, and I make sure my undershirt's matching with my uniform. I mean, you know, it's it's a whole thing.
Yeah, I go with the pastel shoes with my orange and black gloves. So the orange
I saw that.
Is my uniform, but the pastel just pops.
Yeah. I was wearing, you know, because we were rocking our pink uniforms yesterday. So I was wearing those limited edition combatant cleats that Kobe was selling,
and
they just went perfect with the pink, you know, with our pink uniforms, and then you know, rocking my custom Tom Box pink gloves, and you know, hey,
the conversations we have, there's a long delay between plays.
I was just thinking the same thing. Really, guys, really?
Hey, you can't say anything, Eric. I've seen you in GTA 5 and you're matching, so.
That's because I'm awesome.
Okay.
You would right. Be level 30.
Hey, I'm like.
So are they pulling it back? Because nobody's really moving.
Yeah, that's what they're saying in local.
That's what they said, but. That actually happens.
And I'm almost 40 now, thank you very much.
Is that it?
No.
I just started.
You're slacking.
I just started.
Slacker,
I haven't had it a week yet. It's because my ADD kicks in and I just go around killing people.
Yeah. On Xbox, I'm like 102. But okay, I haven't got it on PC.
I just recently got it for PC and have it on PS4.
Yeah, this dude's like level 200 something. Yeah.
Well, Chloe, they were reviewing it. It was actually only two snaps ago. They reviewed it. Razdan was reviewing it, but they kicked it before he had the chance to say that it has to go back. He's not doing the wrong thing here.
Okay, while that happens, I'm going to step away for just a half second. Be right back.
All right, everybody.
Let's do the next sponsor, Hadra. You'll find an array of modern, urban, trendy fashion footwear and accessories, both men and women. Feature mostly mesh products, but also apply-based clothing for the mesh bodies for the ladies as well. Also offer VIPs 300 Linden Vinstore credit every month, regular glyphs, lotteries, and much more.
Yeah, usually, but they were trying to review it when the Cowboys just kicked the extra point.
Yeah, they
didn't get a chance to call the penalty before
Cowboys went ahead and kicked. Which really, Razdan, if he wasn't sure, he should have thrown a referee timeout out there, but...
Alrighty, I have returned.
Well, looks like the Cowboys are running down there. There's only two refs down there, so.
Yeah, that's
not gonna catch everything.
Yeah. So Cowboys have already run down there. They know it's gonna happen, but they're probably deciding on what minute has to be on the board and all that kind of thing.
Well, while we wait, I'm gonna go ahead and cam in on the viewers here. So if you're on the Cowboys side, give a big smile. Good Lord, those are big signs. Jeez.
Like cam over there as well. Let's have a look.
Yeah. Holy moly! So Flo's got his fan section in the group. We've got we've got Chaos over there, and we've got some more Cowboy fans over here as well, all lined up.
He's just mixing up every side.
That's right. Guys, don't y'all know that you're supposed to be on one side or the other? Ah. I'm just kidding. There's no specific sides. I'm just, you know. I'm basically just filling.
Usually, if you're a fan of one team, you stand in front.
You stand near the cheerleaders for that team. What side? Yeah, but hey, you know, nothing has been said official that you have to stand on this side. So, all right, Dre, the kiss cam is on you.
Cowboys have moved down. The Cobras still haven't moved yet.
All right, Dre says, all right, 1 second. All right, here we go. Kiss cam. Not cam Cora, but the kiss camera.
Wait, I've just thought. Karma's holding up a Cowboys sign.
I'm holding up a Cowboys sign?
No, Karma. Flo's girlfriend. But he's on the...
Wait a minute, he's on the Cobras.
Why is she holding up a cowboy sign?
She's putting horns.
Too many cross team families in this league.
I guess so. That's a little confusing.
Yeah. My husband plays for the Cobras, but go Cowboys!
See if I can get a good cam on the refs here.
Where the balls? Oh, they pulled it back even further.
Well, if it's interference, it's a 10-yard penalty.
It's a penalty, yeah.
Oh, and Pit Boss is on the field now, so they've got three referees, so that's good.
Pit Boss to save the day, even though he was playing the game before, wasn't he?
Probably.
He actually got player of the game.
I would say I wasn't sure because I was out driving around enjoying my fast car.
Of course, Tom was not speeding at all. He's not allowed to speed.
Not one bit.
Because that would be illegal.
That would be.
And you're not allowed to say things like that on the stream.
Eric always matches his wife beater to his shoes in GTA. Yeah, you're right, Anna. He does. He does. Until I blow him up. But, you know, I can't say much about GTA because I just bought a second garage to put show cars in.
Oh, that's, yeah. I have two garages, so.
Yeah, like, I basically have a muscle car garage that I put all my muscle cars in, and they just for show. Just for show. There's three of them that I haven't even upgraded yet. And
you need
a
third garage, man.
You can only have two.
No, can have three. I have three.
Oh, well, then I might have to get a third. Jeez.
I think it must have been a loss of down as well.
Yeah, because it's a possession change.
It's fourth down, 10-yard
penalty. No, they took the 10-yard penalty, and the Cobras have the ball.
So Cobras snap the ball. Flo snaps the ball. He's got space to his left here as he runs outside.
Oh, well, that was...
Because they had to man to move the...
Oh, yeah. Well, he got taken down right at the. He got taken down right on the 20, so that should be pretty easy to bring back. And Dre, I agree. You definitely need. You definitely need GTA. It's a lot of fun. There's a lot of laughs that happen. You have like moments of seriousness, and then it just goes haywire for about 45 minutes, and then you're like, oh wait, guys, we were trying to do this. All right. Now they just need to flip possessions twice, and it'll reset the down marker.
Okay, I spent like. What, 30, 45 minutes trying to get away from the cops because you kept getting them back on us?
Me?
Second down and four. Picked up 6 yards.
Yep. And that's easy fixable. Just bring it back 10 yards, unlink them, and then bring it up forward. There you go.
Moving it back a yard at a time.
Hey, I've done that before just to make sure. There you go.
One more.
Man, we are backseat quarterbacking. We are backseat reffing. You know, what's next? Are we going to start backseat cheerleading during the halftime show? Watch out, cheerleaders.
I think I might.
We're going to backseat.
You should have done a backhand spring instead of a backflip.
Oh, that back tuck was really, really terrible. Your knees were not high enough. God.
Point your toes and smile.
Never stop smiling.
Hey Greg, I don't think, are you talking in local, Greg? I can't see it lighting up.
Yeah.
Okay, all right, just making sure,
yeah,
because
it's
you're not.
definitely on.
Okay, yeah, I was just making sure.
If you've muted voice, it won't pop up anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can't. You were just told you'd be. Yeah, Dre, it is a time suck, man. Like, it's. I've definitely gotten lost during play and literally have, like, looked at the time, it's like 5 a.m. So, yeah.
It's a Widowmaker. It
Yep.
is.
It's all right.
So Flo hikes the ball, rolls out to the right-hand side. Hasn't really got the blocks that he needs,
Nope.
although the
He
Cowboys
is
weren't
being
really.
chased by three
But he
throws
throws
it.
it up deep, and
Oh, beautiful
Cobras comes
catch!
through.
Beautiful pass,
Nice
beautiful
catch and big
catch.
Galen there.
Yeah, and that pass was exactly where it needed to be. It went, I mean, he put it over both the heads of the defender and the receiver, and all the receiver had to do was just stand there with his hands outward like he's ready to catch a baby, and the ball just dropped right in. So a beautiful pass by Flo there.
Fake handoff there, Flo rolling out to left hand side after
He's got
pressure
some
on.
room.
You
He's
are.
got the
He's got
angle. Oh.
room. He's got the
Oh wow,
angle.
nice
So
move
he's got an
there.
even better angle
Another nice
now.
move for the touchdown or for the first down.
Be an interesting touchdown in the NFL there.
Yeah, the touchdown area is now from the 40-yard line to
Yikes.
the end zone now. So you make it to the 40, touchdown, you got it. Boy, how games would have been, how games would be different if that was it.
Flo's got on his magic shoes. I can't do it as well as Jace does, but Flo rolls down to the right-hand side. He's got a little bit of gap. He could pick up
Ooh,
four,
thought he
but he
almost crossed the
decides
line
no. He's
there.
gonna drop deep because he's got an open receiver, and it throws
Overthrows
a little
it.
bit too deep for both of those receivers over there.
Little too much mustard on that one, Bob.
A little bit too much mustard.
The mustard again.
I'm channeling my Billy. I'm channeling my Alabamian.
Yeah, since he's
And
got the
Anna's
beard
gonna love
patch
that
on.
one. Y'all got the Destiny bromance going. Yeah, Eskimo kissing over me float. Oh man, Anna's not gonna let that one go. We'll have to sing a song instead of butterfly kisses, Greg. It'll be Eskimo kisses.
Oh, okay.
I'll get the guitar out. The guitar. This is getting bad.
Flo's got 10 seconds left on the play clock.
His running back's not on the ball.
Well, just
He
take the
better.
play anyway.
He better. No, he'll get a
Three,
penalty.
two, one,
And
delay.
delay of
He called
game.
timeout.
Oh, okay.
Did they call that in time? I'm sure they probably did call it in time. It's just the refs were slow on it.
Yeah, probably. Yep, he was
Maybe.
crashing. He's gone.
Dre, I agree. Dre comes out. Who is this Flo guy running like that? It's refreshing to see it. Like, it's really refreshing to see this Cobra team performing, as well. And I promised that I would zoom in on the scoreboard here, and let me go ahead and do that. 2:37 to go.
To be
Seven
fair,
to ten.
when he was playing for the Falcons, he was their running back. They didn't hand it off to him that often,
No.
but it did
That's
happen.
the Falcons rarely ever hand the ball off.
Yeah, but it did happen occasionally. So he has had practice at running. So he's probably been practicing it a bit these last couple of weeks since taking over at QB at the
Absolutely.
Cowboys.
And Flo is the type when he's practicing, he's practicing. I've seen the man work at it. And yes, and I'm channeling my Alabamian. I drove there a couple times, so I feel I got a good feel for the Alabama attitude.
Can you match his impression, though?
I am digging a hole. Can I match his what?
His Bill Clinton
I
impression.
can't do the Bill Clinton. But you know what? Before he started with that Bill Clinton, we were talking about, hanging out. Because I'm neighbors to him in Mississippi, so we were talking about, hanging out, having a cigar, and having a scotch or something, or a beer and something. And then he starts talking about Bill Clinton and cigars. I'm like, whoa, buddy. I don't know if I want to go down that route.
Looks like Mado crashed at the last play there, and they took the timeout to bring him back in. Cobras can't really take a risk of playing without him
until
the change of possession. They really do need to get the points in the next 2 minutes, 37 seconds of the half so that they can... Hopefully, I mean, if they can run the clock and get that touchdown towards the end, give the Cowboys as little time as possible. I'll put them up 14-10 at halftime, and then they give the ball back to the Cowboys.
Absolutely.
So they need to end this with a touchdown, ideally. Although, if they only got a field goal, it'd be 10-all, so that's not so bad. I mean, yeah.
And they're in range. They are in range for a field goal now.
They are already in range. So I would say if you get the fourth down, get
put
the
it,
three
Put
points.
It between the goalpost, exactly.
Mm-hmm. So unless you're not all that confident with your kicking abilities.
Well, it's Flo going to be kicking, and I know that man is comfortable kicking. So
So Flo hikes the ball, rolls to the right-hand side. He's got the blocks he needs to run.
Waiting on one block. He's got that one block he needs. Oh, almost for the first down.
9 yards, third down, and one. The line of the Cobras looking a lot more solid than they have done in recent years. Recent weeks.
There you go.
Receivers looking a little bit better as well. They've obviously been practicing across the board.
Flo and there's the first down.
Down the middle for the first down. Stumbled a little bit, tries to get out, and he doesn't quite. And that brings us to the 2 minute warning.
With all that moving around during the stumble, I was waiting and anticipating that
fumble.
Yeah, I was waiting for it.
Am I right in saying if you're in a fumble and then you try to sprint out of it, that's when the fumble happens?
Yeah, if you're in a block and you're sprinting through it, the percentage of the chance percent goes up.
Really
great little pass there, yeah. Great quick pass
little,
out to the side.
Quick pass to the left there. Gets him another first down. That's not a pass you expect from somebody playing QB for a couple of weeks. That was a really good pass. I did not think this game was going to be like this. So Flo hikes the ball, rolls to the right. He's got a little space if he needs it. He's got the space. He's got the time. He just needs to throw it, and he does down the middle, and it's picked by Fontes. That is unlucky.
Yep. That's what you did not want to do. Keep the ball on the ground. Run it. Pound it up as hard as you can. Take a throw if it's absolutely there, but put it through the uprights. But now you've turned it over. And you're going to give the Cowboys a shot with a minute 19 on the board.
Which they've shown that they can do. So, Cobras, buckle up those helmets and either
absolutely.
Pick it,
pin your ears back.
Either pick it or sack him four times. Or, you know, Cowboys, you know, score a touchdown in two plays. You know, I'm not biased or anything.
Right.
Cobras.
Oh, and a good sack!
And he heard me, Mado heard me, and he kicked the sack for 10 yards. Second down and 20. Timeout by the Cobras. They don't want the clock to run out right now. But the Cowboys are ready to go. Cobra is looking like they're almost ready to go. Probably just wanted to stop the clock because ideally they want the ball back and get another touchdown.
Yeah, they want all the time that they can get, so.
Ball is in play.
Because they've got a lot of ground to cover in just a minute and 12 seconds.
Mm-hmm. Herbert coming in, Mado coming in. But Duggar manages to move all around them. He hasn't really got... Oh, he has got a receiver open down the middle. Galen's open. And I'm pretty sure he's got the step on those safeties. And he does. And runs it to the 10, the 5, the 10.
Oh, and he's teasing it. Oh, there.
Had to hold off on that touchdown. The 10.
Yeah, that's a little... Yeah, that's... Oof.
I don't know if that's classed as showboating or whether he just wanted to waste an extra second off the clock. I don't know, but Touchdown Cowboys.
Well, good. It can't be any worse getting stuck in your celebration dance.
So, next sponsor is something new. Props, poses, and all sorts. Family, couples, singles, and theme props and poses. All priced low, but top quality. And through these ads like anything with all these stoppages. This
week. Absolutely.
So, yeah, as I said at the beginning of the game, that big Durgan to Galen pass right down the middle. I'm pretty sure 2 weeks in a row that sort of play has been in the top five. So, I don't know. That could be a candidate for being in it again this week, I think.
I think there's a certain somebody with a pick six that should be a candidate.
Possibly.
This is my horn, and I'm tooting it.
There was a punt return for a touchdown in the earlier game that could be considered also.
Running it up to sidelines. Gets a good return there, up to about the 31.5.
You don't see punt return for touchdowns all that often.
That is very true. I did actually. I saw that one. That was a good play. I know. I caught bits of the last game, and after it was at a certain score, I was like, "All right, I'm done."
Yeah, I was out in my Miata, so.
So Flo has changed it to the trips to the right. He wants to get the ball down the field as quick as possible. He's got two receivers in single coverage and caught by Mado. I tell you what, I don't know where these Cobras receivers have suddenly come from, but they're catching over the Cowboys right now.
Flo was on point. You know, it took him a little bit to get warmed up, but, I mean, he looks to be on point with these passes. So 9 seconds, the clock is ticking down.
Going to the right.
Going to the end zone.
Yep.
He's got to go straight to the end zone or get rid of it now. And he does. It's deep, but it's
intercepted
by Fontes, and we're into the halftime. Just a quick summary, really. Cowboys 17, Cobras 7 at the halftime. Cobras really in this more than the score gives them credit for. I guess we should probably just head over to the cheerleaders now.
Absolutely. Alrighty. Fantastic job. Oh, let me talk in local first.
Might be an idea.
Try the game. Very well. Welcome back. Welcome back, everybody, to the second half of Sunday night's doubleheader, second game, Cowboys versus Cobras. Current score is 17 Cowboys, Cobras 7. The scoreboard does not reflect whatsoever how this game has been going. The Cobras coming out with a surprising push, you know, to stay in the game. You know, you've had Flo juking and jiving, getting out there with his fancy footwork. Just making plays. You know, each team has answered each team back with some type of points on the board. We've seen some field goals. And now we are joined by Eric. Welcome, Eric. Thank you for joining in, dropping in.
Didn't really have a chance to say hello when you came in.
Yeah, you're just like, poop!
I just kind of popped in, sneaky like that. Are the Cobras missing somebody? I think they might have lost somebody. They're on the locker room, maybe?
Yeah, this Shadow Wolf is in the locker room there. Probably trying to hurry back and wash his hands from going to the bathroom, maybe.
All gotta have that halftime bathroom break.
I know I normally do.
You know, I had a joke there, but...
Well, if anybody that's, like, super involved in, like, awards at the end of the season, we were discussing something at,
Oh, dear. You just want some golden loafers, don't you?
I think we need to, like, a commentator of the year or commentator of the week and get us some golden loafers up in here. And a streamer of the week, too, would be nice.
What would you get for streamer of the week?
Golden camera. There you go.
Golden camera.
Oh, boy. My name's Tom Box, and I do not approve of this message.
Yes, he does. He was all agreeing with it loafers 5 minutes ago. I know you want some golden loafers, Greg.
I can make myself some golden loafers.
Loafers with heels.
I'll be showing up to the Super Bowl wearing my golden loafers with a pimp cane.
Oh dear. Oh dear.
You'd have a feather in your hat too.
Feather in my hat, yeah. I'd have a spring in my step.
Gotta have a girl on it under each arm.
Yep. Although I'm sure Grace won't approve of that. You know.
That's okay. As long as she knows who you're coming home to, it's okay.
Yeah, all right. I'll tell her that and see how she reacts.
Well, she could be one of the girls. There you go.
All right. Yeah. She'll have to approve of the other one.
Yeah, she'll have
and
to.
And
no,
Tom,
other...
you can't put a dress on and be the other one.
The bromance is real. The bromance is real.
Well, if I did that, it would not be a bromance. It would turn into romance. But so you know, we're just gonna keep it at the level of a bromance, and I'm comfortable with that. You know, Eskimo kisses while we.
And t-shirt.
Exactly. Exactly. Yeah, at Bandito. It was just local. I'm just scrolling through
this
local.
Combo
so.
Just went really, really weird.
It did.
Awkward.
Well, I guess since they're taking their time kicking the ball here, I'll talk about the Players Club. The Players Club, founded in 2011, is the home to some of the friendliest staff and VIPs in Second Life. If you're looking for a fun place to hang out, listen to some great music, and meet new friends, check out the Players Club located in the Players Plaza. As you listen to the tunes, take a walk around the plaza where you'll find something for everyone. A new chopper, a new necklace, and of course both men's and women's attire for aspiring designers. We have a full perm texture and template store, and if you're looking to have a new picture done, we have that too. And for all you Ohana Packers fans, the Ohana Packers team store is located in the plaza, so come check out the Players Club and Plaza today. So it looks like Cobra's extra player, the other player come out? No.
Oh, I think
him and Raz are
still back there.
Still out there. Is there a regulated time that halftime has to be?
Not that I know of, but
I don't think so.
I don't think I've read it in the rules that it has to be 10 minutes or it only has to be 5 minutes or... I don't know. Usually it's just as soon as the cheerleaders are done, we're out there.
Here comes Shadow.
Ah, yeah, here they come. But guys, I'm trying to wipe as quick as I can.
People are probably texting him and being like, game's on, guys!
We're on the field, hurry the f... Hurry up!
Hurry the beep!
we need a beep button.
Almost.
Beep.
You almost dropped a bomb on that one. Jeez, man.
Almost dropped an F-bomb. We would've got banned for that one.
First cuss of the season.
The first cuss of the season award goes to Greg.
Wouldn't have got my golden loafers then.
Golden finger.
So, ball is in play. Cobras looking like they could have upset the Cowboys in the first half, but didn't really go their way towards the end of the half, but let's see what they can do this half. Durgan gets the ball in the backfield there, runs it up a little bit, tries to outjuke Kovu, and he gets stumbled and manages to break out from it. He's got space to run it the whole way. It just depends on whose sprint runs out quickest. He's got the gap, Herbert catching up, and it's a touchdown.
Wow, we were just talking about punt returns. We don't see a lot of punt return touchdowns, and there we go.
Wow. Amazing start by the Cowboys. They've come out for this second half and they said,
yeah, we're closing this one down.
This game's over. We're not letting you win this one.
Yeah, the Cobras actually played a player down there because one of them was, I guess, AFK at the kickoff ball, just kind of stood there, watched Durgan run by.
Yeah.
They missed somebody. Yeah.
Now, the perfect time to come back for him would have been as Durgan was getting close and he just shoot over and tackle him, but that's the AFK man trick.
I'm AFK. I'm AFK. No, I'm really standing back here just in case you guys screw up.
All right. Well, while they do this kickoff, let's do another sponsor. Famished. Was it Famished?
Famished. Famished.
Everybody says it differently, don't they?
Well, Veronica made me go actually meet the creator and the owner of Famished, so that way I can pronounce it correctly. Like she literally said, "You were going to meet her before this ad goes on air." She put her foot down.
So Famished is a monthly event that opens on the first of every month. Each month, by top quality original mesh designers to help fill your needs for fashion and home garden designers. We aim to provide the best of the best for the shoppers of Second Life. So it goes out for a touchback. Flo is going to show us what he can do here. Mako's running to the sidelines and into the box.
I think he was the one that was AFK on the last play, so he might be on again. So
looks like he's got a runoff somewhere. And Flo's going to play without him. Rolls to the right hand side.
Big hole in the middle.
Down the middle there.
Durgan with the tackle.
7 yards.
Yeah, that was.
I say Flo had a lot of luck running the ball last half, so.
Yep, he needs to keep it on the ground.
Do it quickly.
Yep. He needs to keep it on the ground, look for passes, and if he doesn't see his pass, go ahead and get that run if he's got the room. His defense, or his offensive line, is creating some good holes.
They are.
You know, for him to run, to give him good running lanes, he's just going to have to capitalize on. And he has been capitalizing on him, so he's just got to get the ball down quick, though.
If I was in Flo's shoes, I think I'd target the right-hand side of the field, because Q's good at getting
the ball. And so a sack, hard sack. Got
Harry Wizard Jr. That's one name I haven't seen this season yet.
Well, that's right, he got steamrolled.
He's usually on the sideline. I just call him Harry Potter.
Well, Harry he Wizard, just steamrolled you know. Straight down the middle and got the sack, losing 11 yards for Flo. Flo's this time is going to roll out to the right hand side. He hasn't really got the blocks he needs this time. He's got a bit of pressure from Durgan, bit more pressure again, He's dropping back and back, and he's got receivers.
There's the
open.
throw.
He sees the receiver.
Just
and
short.
Just
falls right at the receiver's feet. Yep. I know the name is football, but we're not throwing to the feet. And the punt formation coming out.
Yeah, it should be hand egg ball. Flo's going to punt the ball. Good decision, really. Punts it where there's no receiver. Looks like it's going to go out at about 15.
17, close enough.
Yeah, close enough. Not too bad of a guesstimate. The Cowboys now going to have the ball. Now they are ahead. It is currently 24-7.
Their font is taking over at quarterback.
Fontes has been taking over every now and again for the last couple of weeks. Durgan thinking he can trust somebody else.
Yeah, I mean, they've got a comfortable enough lead to go ahead and bring in, you know, somebody else. You know, and if they give up a touchdown, you know, give up a like an interception, you know, they can switch him back. But they've got a little room. And a nice juke Fontes move there.
Loads of room. He does manage to juke through. Really, he shouldn't have even been trying to juke through all those people. But he crossed the line and manages to pick up 26 yards.
Phenomenal run there.
Yeah, really, really good run.
Yeah, I thought he was taking down the backfield. He had so many people around him, and then he just managed to slide through everybody.
See what Fontes can do this time. He rolls to the right. He's
stumbled and tackled. And
taken down. Loss of 5.
By a little 42.
Herbert's a fellow European, so it's 5:30 in the morning for him right now.
Holy moly.
Actually, if he's even more west, it could be 6:30 in the morning. But Fontes taking the ball and Herbert comes in again. Doesn't matter what time in the morning it is, Herbert's picking up.
I think the issue there, I think Durgan went into mouse look to throw the ball and did not even see
Fontes.
Fontes went into mouse look to throw the ball, and I don't even think he saw that linebacker coming in.
Yeah.
He got totally blindsided on that one. Now they got some blocks down. Only rushing only 3 people right now. The other 2 are kind of just holding back. There's the throw. Caught.
Good throw. Good catch. But it's not quite enough to get the first down. It's 4th and 9. And they're going for it. We got Pick, Montana, Harry Potter, and Kalen to the left. Durgan and Tony to the right. Fontes probably going to go over to the left and look for a throw.
He's got a receiver.
Galen open in the middle there.
Oh, he's gone down deep. He's got a receiver deep. Oh!
He's going to run it. He's crossed the line already, and he's running it.
Oh, man.
There's a flag on the way.
I thought he was about to bomb it straight to him. He went. Yeah, he busted that open and just. I mean, just, yeah. See what this flag is going to be.
While the refs do that. Tom, have I ever told you? You play more like a girl. Women's sportswear and accessories look pretty and play dirty while supporting your favorite teams with You Play Ball Like a Girl jerseys, tops, bottoms, and more. Check us out on Marketplace and keep a lookout for some exciting in-world store news coming up soon. Check out our Marketplace store for all your sportswear needs.
I'm about to say, don't we play next weekend?
Darian just made a comment in Twitch chat, Greg, that he wants you to say, "You're a wizard, Harry."
You're a wizard, Harry.
and I'm being told that I need to make Greg say Harry Potter from now on.
Harry Potter. I get that a lot.
He's our fellow Englishman, so he's got to be the one that says Harry Potter, because he can't say it like an Englishman can.
Yeah, I'm not even going to try and do an English accent. I've never been able to do one.
Me neither.
Because when I try to do one, it goes Irish.
Dirty train a turd.
Like, I try to do an English accent, but it always turns Irish, and
Coming back?
A lot of people mistake it for Australian as well.
Interesting.
I never really made that mistake.
No, not a lot of people do, but, like, there's a few.
Yeah, they're similar.
Well, you know, some people say my accent's like a Jamaican, so, I mean, you know, hey.
I don't see it.
Well, I hope you don't see it, but maybe you don't hear it. There you go.
Well, technically, you stream all the time, so technically I would kind of see it, I guess. If you start wearing, like, dreads like Galen one day. I'm gonna start
well, if you watch me tomorrow, you're going to see that there's no way possible right now for me to wear dreads.
You get a wig, maybe.
That's what I'm going to start doing. I'm going to go buy wigs and wear them on stream.
Different wigs.
Yeah. Oy.
I would love to see you with a fro one day. That would be awesome.
A flowing fro of epicness. But no, I'm completely bald right now. So I had a Britney Spears moment earlier.
Yeah, there's a story behind this that. It's probably not suitable for stream. So.
Actually, no. There's actually no real story behind it. To be honest,
while
it was
shaving his head. He was singing, "I am a woman, not
quite. I'm a Barbie girl." No.
Or whatever that Britney Spears song is.
And the oops, I did it. No, I was, you know, I suffered a back injury last month, so I've been pretty immobile for quite some time. And I just got frustrated with having longer hair, and it was all around, it's just really aggravating me. So I went to just do a trim, like just a regular normal buzz cut, and kind of shape it on the sides, and my clippers just kept clogging up. So I just pulled the guard off and just buzzed it all off. Whatever. You know, it's just hair. It'll grow back. I am getting older, so it might take a little longer to grow back, but.
Greg, just for your knowledge, you're Darian's new hero.
Why is that?
I don't know, I just said you're his new
hero. Probably because you said you're a wizard, Harry.
Probably because you said you're a wizard, Harry, so you're his new hero.
Maybe I should apply for player rep for next season and I'll get it straight away.
All right, everybody on the stream now, go nominate Greg. So Greg for president.
Yeah, Bandito, that's pretty much exactly, I was like, whatever. I know my viewers tomorrow are gonna get a good shock. Because I also got rid of the beard too, so.
Oh.
Got rid of
why is
everything? Oh, it's
trimmed
down. So if it was a penalty, loss of downs.
Nope.
I don't know what the call was. Anybody telling us? Because I don't see anything in local.
I don't see anything in local either. I'm not quite sure.
It had was to be a like fourth pass down, so it must have been, yeah.
That's some pass interference.
We'll wait for Bob Kensington to hop in and let us know what's going on.
Us, Rasden.
Hey, Flo rolls to the right hand side. He's looking for a receiver. He's got a couple right in the middle. He's still looking. He's got a man on the out. There's the toss into the middle.
Couple.
Intercepted.
Intercepted.
And intercepted deep back on the 2.5 yard line.
A little bit of pressure here for Fontis or Durgan, whoever decides to take it.
Yeah, the thing is, you're back here on the 2 yard line, and the Cowboys' offensive line hasn't been really doing a great job. Fontis and Durgan have been kind of running for their lives all game, so we'll see how. And right up the middle.
They got him a few yards up.
Picks up 3 yards, and they're on the 5 yard line.
I don't know, I'm probably going to get yelled at for saying that since I'm friends with all three of the linemen, but.
Uh, Manny Manatee, we don't know what the penalty is as of yet.
No, I've just asked Razdan, but he hasn't answered yet. But it looks like it would have been some sort of pass interference, but Fontes runs it again. And picks up 1 yard. Tom, apparently you're really loud on the stream, and I'm kind of faint on the stream right now. I don't know if you can do anything.
Not a block
about
was to be had there.
Yeah, I can work on that just for a second here. Let's see if I can fix it.
Yeah, all three Cobras linemen came in there and were right in Fontes' face, and he just kind of had to throw that away.
So fourth down and 6 yards to go for the Cowboys to get a first down, and they're going to kick it. Cobras has currently got three people in the backfield. They're only allowed two.
I only see
two. There we go. Sorted it out now. Looks like they're a little bit too deep, maybe.
Alrighty, so I have turned myself down and turned Greg up, so let's see how that works.
Cool. So kick is up to the left sideline.
That's gonna
looks
bounce
like it's
way.
Not
going
to
Ooh, and it's
going to
fall dead.
Out. Trey's had to pick that up at the 12-yard line. He's running it back. Tackled at the 27-yard line after a pickup of 14. They didn't do too badly there. It could have ended a lot worse. They could have just left it. And they would have started at, the 5-yard
really
line.
Kick. Really good kick. It just kind of sat right on the sideline at, the 10-yard line. Just chilling.
Had it gone out, Cowboys would have been putting some pressure on. And Flo runs out to left-hand side. He's got room to run it.
Lots of room.
He needs for the first down and picks up 14.
Absolutely. He had that left side completely open. Outside linebacker and the two pass cover guys, the cornerback and the safety, all dropped back into coverage on that one, leaving him just a wide open room to run.
Yeah, and they were a little slow to realize that he was running the ball. He was down five almost at the first down before they started running back to try to get him.
I've received word that the volume change is better, and it's much appreciated.
No problem, whomever was having the issues, I live to serve.
All right, well, Flo manages to pick up 5 yards there. Second down and 5. It's still 24-7.
According to Bob, they can't tell us what happened. I don't know why, but...
Oh, right. Okay.
It must be some, secret agent, super...
Yeah.
Secret referee thing.
Lots of blockers, but a block wasn't had, and in for the sack.
Yeah, Flo trusted his blocker there.
Yeah, and he just ran right. If it had been holding C, he would have got the block. The guy ran right into him.
Yeah.
I know all too well about missed blocks right now, so, I can't rag anybody about that one.
Third down and 16. Cobra is going to have to go big on this one. I don't think he's going to be able to run that much. But he's got space, he's got time, he's got a receiver open deep in the middle.
Intercepted.
Picked off by Sir Fontes. That's another unlucky one. I mean, Cobra's had two receivers there that should have come down with it, but Fontes obviously playing a little bit better today. And a quick snap from Fontes. He drops back 10 yards, 15 yards. Throws it short to Harry Potter.
You're making Inna very happy over there every time you say Harry Potter.
And it goes incomplete, hits the dirt, does nothing. Fontes with the snap. He's got
oh, and a sack.
And Mado takes him down with a loss of...
Whoa! Oh, stop playing music! What the crap? Sorry about that, stream. My Pandora decided to open up and start playing Jay-Z and Linkin Park.
Hate when that happens.
Hunter snaps the ball, drops back deep. He's got the space. He's got the time. He throws it in the middle. Caught
Durgan,
by Durgan.
Right up. Quick
tackled
pass, quick catch.
Straight away by Trey. For a pick up a 17.
And that was a well-executed quick pass there. Mm-hmm. You know, quick snap, had the ball, chunked it to his receiver. That was a very well-planned. Oh, and a nice block and
nice.
A nice move, but doesn't capitalize on it and gets taken down for a gain of about half a yard.
I mean, to be fair, I mean that was a pretty good weave around the defense there.
That was a great move.
But when he got to the outside, he just couldn't get any further. He's having to drop back a little bit deep. He's still in the pocket. Throws it in the middle.
A beautiful catch. Beautiful pass.
And he's gone for a touchdown.
Ooh, in.
Cobras just didn't have the cover there. The MLB was playing too short. Safeties were playing too wide. And that's just magic for Galen's hands and... goes in for a touch.
I don't know how you guys. I mean, that's some dedication you folks over the pond. Wow. I never realized exactly what time it was when these games happened. Like 5 a.m. Holy moly.
Yeah, that's only the late games. So if it's an early game. It was so yesterday I played an early game. It was 12 p.m. midnight.
That's not too bad.
Or 12 a.m. I always get that one. It was midnight anyway. Late game is 3 in the morning. Practice for me Monday to Friday is 2:30 in the morning. And if there's just one game that day, it's 2 in the morning. So Flo with the ball in the backfield. End of the third quarter, going into the fourth now. And he picks up 22 yards after the carry. And they're going to start at the 33-yard line. Cowboys 31, Cobras 7. Is there enough time for the Cobras to come back?
You got 9 minutes. As long as they manage the possessions and get the ball up the field quickly, I think they do. And you got a Cobra standing still on the field. Bunch of blocks happening. He's going to make it up, try to get to the first down. Not going to quite make it. 2 yards shy.
Manages to get a good 9 yards. The problem with him running the ball like this is, I mean,
you eat up so much of the clock.
10 seconds, yeah, whereas if he had thrown it, even if he had missed, that would have stopped the ball, stopped the clock, and they only used 2 seconds instead of 30. So Flo is rolling around to the right-hand side. I think he's got room to pick up the one, but he doesn't. Gets a gain of no yards. Tackled by Pick, who is the MLB. Spying for that run from Flo. Sweeping up anything that the line misses.
I think I'm going to have to change my number next year. There's too many 42s.
So Flo rolls out the left-hand side. He decides to go to the right-hand side for some unknown reason, even though he had tons of space. Crosses the line for the first down.
Stumbled and taken down by Horns.
Taken down by Horns for a pickup of 10 yards. First down and 10, 49-yard line. They're moving the ball, but they're using the clock up as well.
Absolutely. And this is they're eating precious time with 7:33 to go in the game. You know, they've got quite a bit of a deficit there that they've got to come back from.
The Flo rolls to the right hand side, he hasn't really got any pressure at all. He's got tons of open receivers. Mm. And
going
misses
short.
All of them.
All those open guys and nobody catches it.
There was 3 open receivers on that left hand side. Now granted there shouldn't have been that many receivers. There was 4 of them in total over there. One of them was covered. There shouldn't have been that many receivers all over there, but he missed all of them. So.
It happens, you know. You... oh boy!
Again,
oh boy!
Same play again, but
this time he comes down to it.
Comes
yep.
down with it.
And that was one of those much more dangerous ones there.
Yeah, a lot that, more people
that,
covering
that
them.
Play had me confused at the beginning because Flo ran right, but the entire team went left. I was like, where is everybody going?
Well, you know, he could be doing, you know, he could be doing some switches, switching baits. You know, you tell your line to go left, the quarterback goes right. So that makes the defense, you know, if the defense is really reacting off the line.
Well, the line went right. It was just all the receivers went left.
Oh,
and he's got a gap to run, manages to pick up 6 yards again. Cobras are moving the ball here, and they're getting close. They're getting
closed?
Close.
Is that one of those UK words that we don't know?
It must be, maybe. Something that just sounded right in my head. They're getting close to the other end of the field now. They could get a touchdown here, but what do they do after that? Do they onside kick it, or do they just hope that they go four and out with the Cowboys on offense?
I think they're gonna. If they want a chance at it, they're gonna have to onside kick it. And a nice pass, nice catch. Yep. Now they're just gonna have to keep moving that momentum up the field. They're eating so much clock up right now. They're already lost a minute down.
Well, they lost 3 minutes.
3 minutes. Yeah. If they keep eating it this way, they don't have a shot to come back. Just due to the fact that they need multiple possessions of the ball to come back, and just tie the game.
Yeah, Cobras. If any of you are listening, make it quicker. To get this comeback, you've got to be a lot quicker. So Flo hikes the ball, rolls to the right-hand side. He's looking for an open receiver. He's got one short on the left, and he goes for him, standing still. Can't get that wrong.
I thought that was an AFK guy for a second there. I was like, oh, he threw it to an AFK. He's not going to move. Then he moves.
Manages to get the 10 yards for the first down. They're in the red zone here. It's, 11, 12 yards to go for the touchdown. I mean, this is probably the best position they've been in yet. And they're going to have to get a touchdown here.
They're going to have to get a touchdown, onside kick, and another touchdown just to even get close.
Yeah, and Flo's got the gap. He runs it. He's trying to juke around the secondary. Manages to pick up 8 yards. He's got him on the 3-yard line. He's going to have to either find another gap. Now, Cowboys have been good at closing the gap when they're this close because they use the goal line defense when they're this close.
Absolutely, and that's a good defense to use because it's a wall.
Now, on the flip side of that, you could take that to your advantage, run both your receivers on that left-hand side straight to the corner.
Absolutely, fake handoff there.
But he's not going to do that. He's going to look for a gap.
Oh, and they close the gap.
He makes it for the first. Yeah, he gets the first down.
Should be a first, it looks like.
Yeah, it should be. They're overlapping, so that should be a first. Clock is still running. They've used up half of this quarter. 4 minutes left on the clock.
Yeah, I don't see a comeback coming with this right here. Just with the time needed.
Yeah. While they sort that out, I'm going to talk about the Cabana, a friendly club featuring the best in classic rock, top 40 country, romance, laughter, fun, family, great music. And that is the Cabana, I believe. It's actually one of the Cowboys' favorite clubs. Do you know why that is, guys?
Because it's on their sim, isn't it?
Yeah, it's on their sim and it lags up their practice facility.
As a touchdown.
And Flo gets the 1 yard touchdown there get the first down.
I'd also like to congratulate the Cobras on that touchdown because that touchdown means that they've scored more points in this game than they have the entire season.
Wow.
They've only scored 7 up until this game and now they're 14.
Well,
now they're going in the right direction.
Congratulations to the Cobras. Yeah, I mean, they've had an unlucky season. They picked up some key players, really, Flo and Kovu, after they left the Falcons right when the rosters were closing.
Yeah, I think that was a big pickup for them.
Yeah, and I mean, if they can stick with it and practice on the off season next season, you could see a solid team that's putting points. I mean, they're putting points up against the Cowboys right now. Like with an off season,
hopefully
next season.
Exactly. Hopefully you'll see, you know, games like this all season long, you know, from the Cobras next year.
I mean, you may not have come out and won this, but next season you come out and play the exact same Cowboys team and you win it.
Oh, there's the onside kick and it's grabbed by the Cowboys.
Unfortunately, Pick gets that one. just didn't bounce in the Cobra's favor, really.
Yeah, well, it was a little too deep. He needed to kick it a little more a little more of an aggressive angle towards the sidelines for those to work. You really got to kick them just right at the 10-yard mark and really, really hard towards the sideline to really make those work.
And Fontes snaps the ball. There. And a little bit of a stumble. Gets back to the line of scrimmage, though, for a gain of nothing.
But, that was like a jailhouse break there. All three Cobras that were rushing just came right through, and Fontes didn't stand much of a chance.
Yep. Fontes sticking at QB. We've got Pick, Harry Potter, and Galen on the left. Durgan and Tony on the right. Fontes dropping back.
Some great blocks. Short. Just right at the feet of Durgan.
Yeah, Durgan short there, but just threw it a little bit short. Fontes still getting used to the QB position. He normally plays about half a game each game for the last couple of weeks, and you've really got to play a little bit more than that just to fine-tune things, and I think he's just at that stage where he's just fine-tuning. But Fontes drops back deep again. Comes back forward to throw the ball out to the left.
Beautiful. Oh, and if he can get away. Oh, man.
He was stumbled by Trey and then taken down by Mako. That was a good catch. Good catch. So Fontes once again knocking on the Cobras' front door. See if they can get a touchdown from this.
And a nice move around the defender there to open up.
Around the defender, cross the line, goes for a run, almost picking up 10. He picks up 8 yards, second down and 2 on the 15-yard line.
Eric, did a jet just take off in your room?
Yes. yeah, that was me at my AC.
I gotcha.
We're hooking up.
Tony looks like he might be lagging or something.
Play
was stopped. Timeout Cowboys. Looks like they might have had a crash player. While they sort out the crash player there, let's talk about Odyssey. Odyssey Music Live Venue, an elite live music venue established originally in 2006. That's how long I've been on Second Life. We'll continue bringing only the best to you in SL. Watch for weekly events at facebook.com/groups/112421605485275, and I'll paste that in local for those of you who couldn't keep up with my talking.
And I haven't really done too many player zooms, so let me get some up close and personals with the players. That is a really big helmet, Horns. If you're listening to this stream, that is a massive helmet.
Yeah, it doesn't look like she's resized it.
She just turned and looked at the camera angle almost perfectly, like she heard me and knew exactly where my camera was pointed. I think I do have cursors on.
Crash player is out of here. Who have they bought on instead? Superficial Swag is out to catch now. Font is dropping back. He's got a little bit of time, a little bit of pressure. Throws it short to Durgan. Durgan
in for the touchdown.
For a touchdown.
And that is going to, if it wasn't already closed, that's going to widen the gap and go ahead and bring the win for the Cowboys.
To be fair, I mean, the Cobras have played strong.
Absolutely. You can't.
First half, you could have said the Cobras were going to win this.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
But yeah, the Cowboys definitely sealed it this second half.
And now what we have to discuss is player of the game. And that's going to be a difficult decision because a lot of these players have been making key plays on the Cowboys.
Yeah, I mean, you've got Galen with the deep touchdowns.
You've got that almost 80-yard run back too from a kickoff.
Durgan, yeah, that was Durgan.
Yeah, that was that Durgan.
So I'd vote for either Durgan or Galen. So let you guys fight it out. I'm just a third wheel here in your romance.
I don't know. I'm going to have to think about it.
I agree. It's kind of the same way here.
Ball is deep to Kovu. Picked up at the 11-yard line. Does a little bit of juking, a little bit of diving. And it's fumbled. And picked up by a Cowboy. Galen coming up with it. That is unlucky. That's very unlucky.
That's how the fumble works, I'm convinced. Oh, you're down by 3 touchdowns? Here's a fumble. You want to get back in this game? Nope.
Yeah, I'm constantly told to stop eating KFC before practice. My hands are too greasy, and I end up fumbling the ball.
Well, you know, Greg, you should head over to Combatant and get you some new gloves that are not all like greasy and you know. Oh, and a beautiful pass, beautiful catch for the touchdown.
I think that's about to sway your decision on player of the game there.
To be fair, I think it does. I mean, Galen has constantly gotten into space, constantly shown that he can, you know, get that space and then get the touchdown after. My vote goes to Galen. And I know Galen wins it for like every Cowboys game, but you know, he's such a good receiver for them.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to agree. I'll put my vote in the hat on for Galen as well.
Alright, so wow, Galen yeah. It is, and they're wow. going for the 2 points. But it doesn't work.
Oof.
I
was not even ready for that camera movement.
So the last sponsor of the night is the Shining Starlets. Tom, we got to dance with them this weekend.
We did get to dance with them, and hopefully I'll get to do it. Hopefully we'll get to do it again sometime. That was really enjoyable.
It was fun.
I think this... No, this is my first time dancing. The last time I danced was with the UFL team. Yep.
Squad, yeah.
Yep.
So Shining Starlets Dance Troupe is an energetic, fun dance group that choreographs and performs dance showcases covering multiple genres and dance styles. They create sets and costumes to fit the event theme. The Starlets have danced for a variety of events such as Relay for Life, 1 Billion Rising, and Second Life's birthday celebrations. For information on upcoming Shining Starlet performances, you can visit our Facebook page at facebook.com/shiningstarlets or their blog, which is shiningstarlets.wordpress.com. To book the Starlets at your next event, contact Caden Piers in World. We got to do a Pitch Perfect themed dance.
Absolutely. That was a lot of fun.
The girls had something like 6 different outfits that they had to wear across the thing, and we only had to come up with 2, which I'm kind of glad of sometimes.
Well, they say, you know, wear a casual shirt. I'm like, I don't think I have a casual shirt, and I got told real quick, fast, and in a hurry that I do have one. Mom let me know. She's like, you've got one. Wear this one. I'm like, oh, okay, I'll wear that one. Minute 33 on the clock. Cowboys lining up for the kickoff to the Cobras to give the Cobras another shot at putting some extra points on the board before this game is on a wrap.
Yeah, I mean, this game wasn't really a decider or anything for the playoffs, but it definitely shows that the Cobras have got the power to beat possibly, you know, a team like the Cowboys next season. If they practice hard and carry on improving the rate that they are next season, they could do a lot better than they have this season.
Absolutely. I mean, they shouldn't be upset about this at all whatsoever. This has been one of the best showings that I've seen from the Cobras.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, you've put up more points than you have the rest of the season against the team that's ranked within the top 10 or within maybe. I think they're about 8 or something, aren't they? On the power rankings.
I am not quite sure.
I missed it this week, so I don't know.
I missed it this week as well. I can't even remember why. I think my internet was playing up.
Flo is dancing for his life there.
Flo dances around, runs to the right-hand side, decides to run it, picks up 10, 20 yards before he's taken down by Pick Montana. There is a minute and 1 second left on the clock for the Cobras, just to prove that the fight has not gone, and they're going to try and get another 7 points. Trey's running a little bit slow there. There he is. Flow should do this straight away.
Absolutely.
Flo hikes the ball, he's got a wall in front of him, so he decides to go to the right, crosses the line, jukes horns a little bit, gets stumbled, rolls around a little bit, gets out of that, picks up six, second down and four on the 47.
It looked like on my screen that he picked up just a little bit more than six, and then when the line of scrimmage was put down, it looked like it was put down a little behind him.
Yeah, it looks like they...
So 12 seconds to go now. 10 seconds. Looks like this might be the last one.
There's a dead ball penalty. Dead ball penalty. 9 seconds left on the clock.
And as we wait for that penalty to get assessed, congratulations to who we choose, Galen?
Galen, yeah.
Galen for player of the game.
Not to take away from Durgan, I think the play of the game goes to Durgan's punt return.
Absolutely, I wholeheartedly agree.
So you will see that up on the voting thing on should be Tuesday.
Looks like the penalty was there was an offensive player not on a pose ball.
I thought there was.
That's just what I'm seeing someone say in chat, yeah. So I'm not 100% sure.
I thought they were, but they haven't called what it is. They've just said a 5-yard penalty against the Cobras, so
someone's, not a big deal, really. Someone's saying no cadence. They got the time back on the clock, so they got 12 seconds back on the clock now.
Yeah, I mean, luckily, I mean, it stops the clock. It puts the clock back where it was. Gives them another chance. I know they're 5 yards behind, but, I mean, technically, he can technically throw it to about the 10-yard line and then just get the guy to run in the extra 10 yards.
Plenty of room on the left to look and find a receiver. The coverage, though, is pretty stout right now.
Yeah, he's...
Oh, I knew that toss up right there was coming, and throwing it out. And that's ball game.
That brings us to the end of the game. Cowboys 44, Cobras 14. Really good show by both teams. At the beginning of the game, I thought the Cobras were actually going to possibly upset the Cowboys and actually win this game.
Wow, the Cowboys disappeared fast.
Cowboys, obviously, they were predicted to win this game this week, and they didn't disappoint. They got the win, but not a convincing win, I must say. Not until the second half, so good game, both teams.
Absolutely. Alrighty, well, that's going to do it for this game. As Greg said, final score 44-14. Congratulations on the win from the Cowboys, and congratulations also on the Cobras for a phenomenally well-played game. I want to thank everybody for tuning in on Twitch as well as in-world. We always thank you guys for your support for these teams, for this league, and for all that we're doing. So, I'm Tom Box, and that is Greg, and that is also...
Eric,
there we go. And Eric sitting in the... Oh, boy, he's going to kill me in GTA. I know it. So... That is us three, and we're going to go ahead and call it a wrap, because I know Greg probably wants to go to bed.
Yeah. Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Good night, everybody.